cutting cedar shingles. Sitting here outside the Hangar Cafe, close to Miller, Missouri. Waiting on Ron and Ethan to finish their airplane ride, listening to some music. I hope you can hear it in the background there. Having us a pretty good afternoon today. More later. Ethan going for an airplane ride. All right, everybody, welcome back. I don't know why I said welcome back. This probably won't be the start, but anyway, you gotta hurry and get chores done. I don't know if you can hear that over the pig, but we got some weather coming, so we're gonna try to hurry and get these chores done here real quick. They know what's going on.
Good thing I'm over here.
Yeah, thanks, buddy. Your fault.
All right, whoo, that was a chore. For anybody's got any questions there, somebody has donated us a bunch of old milk, and the pigs love it. They prefer it over anything else. If we'd let them, that's all they'd eat. You know, they're like kids. They just want to eat what they like. But they go nuts over it, and that's why the big fit. So, just in case she was curious about that, that's what it is. They're all getting big. Can't get this pen to drain any better than it is. I might have to get in there tomorrow, move some stuff around. Need to get that rubber dish out of there before it gets completely lost. Now, I don't know, like I said earlier, got some weather coming in, they say. Might have to try out the new shelter. Hope not. I honestly hope I never have to go into that thing. But anyway, it's there if we need it now, so we got that peace of mind. I'm going to turn this around and take a look at the weather up here. See, it's getting pretty dark back here to the northwest. Little band right there. It's not very wide. I don't know what it's got on its mind, but looks like it's headed this way. Some pretty cool fluffy looking clouds there. They got a special name, but you know, maybe the weather dude knows. I don't know. Anyway, be back in a little bit with some more. Okay, that's been a good day. Enjoyable day for us. We got a wild hare this morning, and I'd seen on TV last night that they were having an antique tractor show over at the Hangar Cafe down by Miller, Missouri. So me and Ethan discussed it last night, and then we talked it over with Rhonda this morning, and she was game, so we went over there, and that's what we did most of the day, hang out over there. By the time you're watching this part of the video, if you've stuck around that long, you'll see some of the video I shot there. They had some old, really, really cool stuff there. Especially if you like antique tractors. I do. You'll learn. I have a wide variety of interests. Mechanical stuff really fascinates me. Especially the old stuff, you know. And, you know, whether it be cars, trucks, motorcycles, tractors, I'm fascinated. I enjoy it. And I enjoy, you know, thinking about the, you know, from doing it by hand, you know, cutting wheat or hay or oats or whatever with a scythe, up to getting a sickle bar tractor mounted implement to, you know, we looked at it's probably, I don't know, I'm guessing. If any of y'all that know or that are subscribers, if you're watching this video and you know what this stuff's properly called, we looked at a couple pieces of machinery, and I got some pictures of them that, if not in this video, this may be a 2 or 3 part thing to keep these videos short or at a reasonable level. You know, I know y'all don't want to watch for an hour or so, but I would call it a wheat shocker, or, you know, because it cuts the wheat and bundles it and leaves it laying on a field like a shock of wheat, you know, but it actually wire ties it. I wish I'd have got it on video, but the guy was explaining it to another guy there, and it's pretty interesting. I wish we could have got to see it actually working. But, you know, it's how it is. You know, and if you like this, be sure you let me know. You know, give me some comments. There's another tractor show, if it doesn't get canceled, going to be at the Lamar Fair, which we usually go to the Lamar Fair, and I'll probably have some stuff there. It's towards the end of August. So, you know, you can be looking forward to that if they don't cancel it. A lot of stuff's been canceled. The 4th State Farm Show has been canceled this year. And I think it's due mostly to the fact that it's going to be, or was going to be this year, on the grounds of Pittsburgh State University and some of it being inside this year. But anyway, don't want to dwell on that. So, if you enjoyed this footage, hit that like button. Leave me some comments, you know. Tell me if you want more of it, less of it. What do you want? Like I said, it may take up 2 or 3 days of my little YouTube videos here. And anyway, okay, let me explain why we didn't get a video last night. Well, me and Ethan tried to use the camera. We shot some footage of me transplanting a tomato for Rhonda. And in my little dialogue at the end that I usually do. Well, we got some pig footage before that. Well, Ethan has been telling me he wanted to be my cameraman. So I'm like, okay, fine. You know, if we use that other camera, that would make it easier for me. He neglected to tell me that he didn't know how to focus. So everything he took was out of focus. So no video last night. But that's all right. We're learning. We had fun doing it. You know, I did. You're not going to be able to tell it because you're not going to see it because it's all out of focus. Everything behind me, way behind me, was in focus, but I was out of focus. I don't even know how to explain it. Just out of focus. I figured it'd give somebody a headache trying to watch that. They probably get a big enough headache with me rambling on like I do. But anyway, that explains that. Anyway, so if you like this footage, this video tonight, if I can get it put out, we're going to try to edit it all on the computer, which I've not had much success so far, but last night I thought I was figuring things out. But anyway, we'll see, because some of it will have been shot on the good camera, some of it on my phone. This right now is on my phone because the battery on the good camera was dead from everything we did today. I'm going to try, probably won't be tonight, but Rhonda shot some footage on her, some video, whatever you want to call it, footage, video, whatever, on her camera of something that her and Ethan did today. That may be on tomorrow's video. I don't know. I'm going to try to get it download, get her to let me download it into the computer and put it in a camera. But anyway, you see me looking over my glasses. I'm trying to see how much time I've used because I'm running out of storage space on my phone again. But anyway, we're in good shape right now. And the reason I can't see is because my glasses are for distance and not up close. I can see just fine up close. I know that's hard for some people to understand, but it's a fact of life for me. And anyway, I think I've been long-winded enough because I need to cut down the pig footage tonight, or try to. So hopefully the storm don't shut the power off. It's getting a little closer. I don't know if you heard the thunder there, but it's getting a little closer. So I'm going to wrap this up here. Did you hear that? Anyway, if you like what you see tonight, hit that like button. Like I said, leave me some comments. Let me know, you know, let me know things that you'd like me to see. Maybe we can make it down there and look at it. Like I said, this video is about farm-related stuff, or this YouTube channel. You know, I don't know. I'll go to the Lamar Fair. I'll probably sneak in some motorcycles and some cars, hot rods, you know, that sort of stuff, along with the farm stuff, because I like that stuff. In case you don't know it, I've got a 1974 Harley-Davidson Sportster in the garage that I need to get to working on and get back on the road. You know, it's not your basic Sportster. But it's just a little hot rod kind of deal. It's, you know, it's fun and enjoyable for me. But like I said, it needs work, like a lot of things around here. You know, if y'all would get to liking this and more of you watching these videos, you know, make me YouTube rich, then I just have the time to work on all this stuff. You know, give me making enough money off of YouTube by, you know, quit my job and just show you videos of stuff going on around home here. Because I know they're not going to let me show you any videos at work. And besides that, that'd bore you to death. Anyway, like I said, for you subscribers that have subscribed already, I appreciate it. I appreciate everybody that keeps coming back and watching. If you haven't yet, please subscribe. I think I'm getting better. You know, my editing needs some work still, but we're working on that. We're going to work on, you know, finding some kind of editing software that I can get downloaded and maybe help me out. But anyway, if you like it, hit the like button, subscribe, you know, turn on that notification bell so they'll let you know when I put some of these semi-coherent ramblings out there. So anyway, let's all look out for each other, try to help each other, and let's pray for each other, because that's really important now, because, you know, I don't think in this video I've mentioned how crazy it is out there in the world. It's pretty peaceful and quiet right here right now, you know, which is why I'm right here right now. You know, I like where I live. My neighbors are good people. So anyway, until next time, we'll catch you later. Oops. We got baby kitties. I like baby kitties. Got a couple orange ones somewhere. I just spent 5 minutes rambling on about the kitties and didn't have the video turned on or the audio. Look, this one's begging, wants some food. Rhonda just fed it.